Hello everybody, welcome to another video where I explain a fitting and show some footage as well. This time it's a T1 cruiser. In my opinion, it's the best T1 cruiser for the ESS. As you can see right away here, a fellow Nilesackers decide to 2v1 me in two caracals, and I utilize my ability to be at zero from the start and just win the DPS race against these fairly poorly fitted caracals and actually win the 2v1 against these rapid light caracals, which would not be possible necessarily in some other circumstances where they warp to 20 at the gate and I have to burn to them and scram and web them, have less tank. But this Cinnamon web fit with a pure tank actually can do some work. Being a T1 cruiser, most PvE guys in Nilesack don't really respect it that much. So this Gila actually warps in. He was previously ratting in an Anom, and as you can see, I can heat my invuln the whole time. It's not too much heat. Even the boost amp, which increases the heat generation, doesn't prevent me from heating all my tank mods, and I can wear this fairly tanky Gila down over time. I have some really nice DPS with the Void and double max step. I do like, I think, 700, a bit more than 750 DPS heated, and this is a really nice kill in a T1 MOA against a like 300-400 million Gila, and it's also nice loot. Another targets, common enemy is the Ishtar. Obviously, Gilas and Ishtars are rating in Nilesack most of the time, and if you pick your targets or systems correctly, you anticipate by the number of the ESS in the agency how much actually is in local and who is ratting, right? So if it's between 20 and 50 million, it's most of the time it's one or two Gilas or Ishtars. So you go there, you take the money, the Ishtar sees the MOA in the ESS and he thinks, ha, I'm in a T2 cruiser, let's go, and you defeat this most PvE fits quite easily. Obviously, it doesn't really work all the time. Some variations in the enemy fittings are quite scary. This year, you see the effect on the Ishtar right now. It's an ADC double armor wrap Ishtar, and both are the same fit. So I didn't really get a chance of splitting the Ishtars. I'm happy to, fight both, but the ADC basically gave him so much time that I couldn't DPS race him fast enough, right? It's still an insane fact that I killed one Ishtar, but I won't kill this second one. I spent too much time against the ADC, and this one will have you see the effect right now. He's ADCing right now, so I can't kill him in time. I'm in my last charge of the Ancil. I am out of heat in my guns, and I will pop here in a second. But still, I killed one Ishtar and almost killed the second one, which is a pretty big success in my book. Now you see, obviously, not every Nilesacker wants to bring a fair fight or like a reasonable fight. You see here that you still need to be cautious about local movement, and you need to look at D-scan actively to see what's going on the outside, and just escape with heated ABs when you can and when the enemy doesn't bring webs, because you can still be outside the ESS in 1 or 2 minutes, like 60 to 80 seconds. You need escaping. Praxis is not a good target. This Ishtar shows it's showing again what the difficulties you could have sometimes when a slight variation of the PvE fit is there and just outtanks you, and you can't break it with 750 DPS. This time is a common XL booster on the Ishtar, and I sit here thinking, I can't break him. I heat it for like 1 minute or so. I need to get off. So you just align off. You swap to defanging Ishtars, which lowers the incoming DPS by quite a bit, and you just hope that you can reach the end. And you need to make that decision early enough in the fight, right? If you don't see him break, basically just pull off instantly, because shield tanks obviously are not Enzil, or PvE fits are usually not Enzil. You can be pretty sure that he won't refit for your fight. He will just warp in what he previously used for retting. So it's a pretty fair call to just instantly pull off once you can't break him. This time here chose a Phantasm going into me. Obviously not the best opponent for you, but in my head I was hoping that he is not web fit and he is a fairly slow Phantasm, so not super blink, not snakes, maybe just a tech 2 tenement, and then theoretically I might be able to have range control over him. But you see, I didn't really account for my difficulties tracking him, because he's still in bonus AV ship. He's still doing enough velocity basically to out track or like get under my guns, and I can't track him basically. So I make the decision to go for the outside. He doesn't track me as well, which is a key factor basically. He has pulse, but he doesn't track me. And he doesn't keep at range, because he might be afraid of me getting DPS done, which you actually can see here. Here I don't try to keep at range, and he is trying to keep up with me, or like just burn after me, and then he actually, I have good tracking against him, which almost basically depletes his Enzil. I think he's Enzil fit, but obviously he can decide to pull away fast enough, and then he doesn't really want to go into me into more, because it's just a big risk for him to take now if I somehow get tracking. But yeah, here you're gonna see some more sad footage where you can't really escape fast enough. Sometimes it's just no enemy, and then instantly they undock Bargo, Dominix, and you can't really pull off in time, and you're stuck at like 40 kilometers outside TSS. This particular Vargo is a arty Vargo, so I won't die instantly, but I will die here once I have enough range from him. This time here, this Ishtar here that ratted, I was hoping he would warp in, but no. He was a pretty smart guy, and he refit, or like he reshipped to a curse. Out of nowhere, I didn't know he's refitting. I just thought he's re-shipping. I just thought he's docked, and then obviously the curse is not even close of a fair fight. You don't have a cat booster, and it's just instant GG. He got pretty low in the structure, but only because he was not tanking very well. Right, let's talk about the fitting. The main idea is to fully utilize the ESS environment, so that the enemy you know that the enemy warps to you at zero and you're already on top of him and start with void DPS instantly, and then the Tenement and the Web are the only tools you need to maintain range control over most enemies you want to fight, so Ishtas, Gilas and other T1 cruisers. And the rest of the fitting is purely dedicated towards tank and DPS, of course. So the multispec and the boost amp together with the XL Ancel gives you an amazing value of tank. More than, well, almost 65k EHP, sorry, 75k EHP in total. Some EHP per second if you boost only if you have low shield and then maximize the passive recharge, you can get to some really good values. You do 760 DPS heated. You can heat quite a while. Most of the times if you're in a 1v1, it's you can heat all the time. And obviously these numbers do get generated by some utilities or some extras to the fit, like the strong proof pill and the Pyrolancer 2, as well as level 2 implants, which are quite costly in total. It's like 56 million for the character implants or boosters itself, and then the fitting itself is 85 million. So it's fairly expensive for a T1 cruiser. You can obviously downgrade the blue pill to improved and leave the pyro. I would not leave the implants because they are pretty cost efficient, and anything else can't really get downgraded. You need the T2 Ancel and you need the storyline processor. So all in all, it's like 130 million, but or like 140 million even, but most of the times you can actually get ISK positive, right? If you kill a Gila, which is 100% possible in this fit, or an Ishtar, and loot some faction extenders or some drones, as well as the ESS accumulated where the enemy doesn't fight you, and then you can escape through Poshwen into Jita when you don't have time left, or like, yeah, when you're done roaming and you can filament out to safety. You actually get a fair amount of loot back. So I would recommend using the extras here, the implants and boosters, and then yeah, just have fun with the vid and kill some unexpected nullsackers.